big bounds out of her corner. Looks for an early takedown attempt. Inside leg kick from Daymonster. Right hand from Daymonster. Heavy right hand from Daymonster. Single leg from the zombie.
Cardoso's landed some serious shots. But this is where Miura wants to be. Wants to be inside that clinch, working her way up to the body. Daymonster might try to jump on the neck, but good job defending from Miura.
Daymonster full of aggression from the opening get-go here.
Yeah, she's got really heavy hands. This is where Miura wants to go. I don't know, she might try to jump guard. There it is. There's that head and arm. Uh-oh, gives up her back, though, in the process. She's okay to do that just as long as she gets here, Michael. Right now, she's in that scarf hold. You can see how Cardoso is trying to slide out the backside and trying to get to her back, but because of the arm that she's got, and this is a specialty of Miura, watch her try to take that left arm now and shove it in between her legs. This is exactly where Miura wants to be. Uh-oh, look at that beautiful job by Cardoso to pop out the backside.
Tremendous work from Cardoso. Has the back standing of Miura.
That's like day one right there of BJJ school, is they'll immediately teach you how to slide out the backside once somebody gets that headlock position, and nobody has ever been able to do that to Miura.
Confidence boost indeed for Daymonster, back on the ground again.
Nice little sacrifice throw from Miura right there, but, you know, I was talking to the coach of Cardoso, and they were saying that she was not scared to go to the ground with Miura, and we're seeing that right here, but this is ultimately where Miura is so tough. She wants that head, she wants to control that arm in that headlock position, and now she's just gonna try to get to that scarf hold, but Cardoso's doing a good job of just trying to set up this crucifix right here, but there it is. There's the scarf hold position. Now she's gonna take that arm and shove it underneath her left leg, and it's gonna create a torque on the shoulder of Cardoso. Good job so far of Cardoso to try to sneak around the backside. See how she's trying to get a hook? But Miura is so tough right here. She's so strong in this position, it's really hard to get out of it once she gets you there. And Cardoso's trying to pop out the backside, trying to go belly down. Miura's doing a good job of just kind of floating on top. There she, oh, good job to trap up one of those legs by Cardoso, but it still leaves her arm in danger. Miura's gonna try to create separation on that grip that Cardoso has. She can't do her scarf hold arm lock from without the extra leg, so she needs that leg to really bridge into the position and to create that torque on the shoulder. So that holding the leg right there for Cardoso in that half guard position right there is very important. But Miura is able to pop that leg out. Beautiful job. Now she's gonna try to settle into the position. I think some of the explosiveness might be gone from Cardoso. So Cardoso needs to focus on technique here. She has to be very composed and not leave herself exposed, especially her left arm. That's the danger zone right there. That's what's in threat right now. She's trying to keep her leg, her arms locked so that she doesn't separate the arms and trap that arm.
1 minute 20 remaining in this opening round. Miura, who wanted to show the world she was not just a one-trick pony, she'd added to her arsenal after that loss to Zhong Jinan in her attempt for the strawweight world title. You see Cardoso, the monster, closing down Miura.
I'm impressed with this defense, Michael, by Cardoso right here to keep her arms trapped like that.
She's strong and disciplined.
Here's Ayaka trying to settle back into the position, but good job by Cardoso to, again, trap that leg and retain sort of a, you know, back half guard.
A back half guard?
That's kind of cool. She's in half guard just from the reverse side, reverse half guard.
It's fine with me. Looks, sounds good. Back half guard it is.
Right, she's basically got one hook, right? She's got one leg trapped and taking the back, but she's got her head still trapped in that, you know, headlock position with the arm right there.
15 seconds to go in this round. Don't forget, we are judged as an overall contest, not round by round.
10 seconds.
Cardoso will get the chance to recommence from the feet. at the start of the second round. Fita land those heavy salvos again. Miura tears out of her corner, shoots in for a low Sakuraba-style single. Cardoso thought about the outside fire kick, hesitated though. Again shoots in, nice sprawl there from Cardoso.
Yeah, but she's just gonna run out of real estate there as Ayaka Miura is able to back her up against the wall. She's got a good heavy sprawl. Let's see if Miura here can turn the corner and transition into a different takedown. That's the thing about Miura though, she doesn't really chain together the takedown attempts quite well. Once you stop one initial takedown, she doesn't really have that plan B. She doesn't go to that second takedown attempt. And that's what we're seeing right now. She goes back up into the body lock and she usually likes this position here. Let's see if she can go for one of those judo style throws. Good job by Cardoso here to utilize the overhook and create a little bit of space and separation. Oh, right hand, landed. Ted touched her. Oh, hurt her.
Oh, it's over.